In order to solve a linear equation, the goal is to isolate the variable on one side of the equation. So our goal is to manipulate this equation so it's in the form of x equals some number. So when we see 8.5x, we need to recognize that that means 8.5 times x. So we need to undo this multiplication in order to isolate the variable x. So if we divide both sides of the equation by 8.5, here we have 8.5 divided by 8.5, which is equal to 1, and 1 times x is x. So this does isolate the variable x, and on the right side we have to perform this division. And since this division involves a decimal, we'll set this up in long division form. So we'll have 39.95 divided by 8.5. But when performing division involving a decimal, we want to make this divisor a whole number. So we want to move the decimal point to the right one place to make this 85, and we can do this as long as we do the same to the dividend. So we'll move the decimal point to the right one place here as well, and then up into our quotient. Now we'll divide as we normally do, and if needed, we can add zeros to the right without changing the value of the dividend. So the first question we want to ask is, how many 85s are there in 399? Well, I know 5 is going to be too large. Let's try 4. 4 times 5 is 20, carry a 2. 4 times 8 is 32, plus 2, that's 34. If this difference is less than 85, this 4 is correct. So we have 9 minus 0, that's 9. 9 minus 4, that's 5. And 59 is less than 85, so the 4 is correct. Bring down the next digit, which is 5. And now we want to know how many 85s there are in 595. If 4 times 85 was 340, we should probably try 6 or 7. Let's try 7. 7 times 5 is 35, and I carry a 3. 7 times 8 is 56 plus 3, that's 59. And that's good news because this difference is 0, which means this decimal terminates, and our solution is x equals 4.7. And let's go ahead and check this. If it's the solution, then 8.5 times 4.7 must equal 39.95. And it checks. I hope you found this helpful.